Well, Kelly, we're told that people started lining up at 8 a.m. That's 2 hours before the Carnegie Science Center opened. So if you think this line is long, they told me that this morning it went clear behind Sportsworks, that building, around the Sportsworks, up this sidewalk, and back to where this orange cone is and where you see this crowd of people here. As you can imagine, everyone is super excited, and we helped people pass the time while they were in line. Here's what the youngsters had to say.
It's gonna get like really dark outside, and you can't like look right at it or else your eyes will get hurt.
I might go blind.
You might go blind. Why do you say that?
Because I might want to look at the sun.
Weren't you told not to look at the sun?
Yes.
It's so rare to do this, and so many people will travel all over the world to get a chance to see an eclipse. The fact that it's just crossing the entire country, this is so amazing. Won't happen again in my lifetime, never did before. So, I am really pumped.
The Science Center says it has more than a dozen telescopes for people to view the solar eclipse from. They also have about 700 of these eclipse glasses. So unfortunately, people are going to have to share, but that should be okay since they're expecting more than 2,500 people to come into the Science Center to view from three different platforms. And everyone thinks that they're going to have an incredible time because they have so much to offer, including shows. They said the shows, unfortunately, are sold out, though, but you could still come to the Science Center to be part of this history, to learn from the best, those experts. So reporting live from outside of the Carnegie Science Center, Alyssa Raymond, Pittsburgh's Action News 4.
Hang on to those tight. Do not let them go. Those are the hot commodity, those
hot
glasses.
Commodity.